Also, just I think one thing that we could do, maybe you would agree, in the particular case of Khalida Jarar, as fellow parliamentarians, this committee should, in fact, I think, make some representation to the Israelis to say it's outrageous that somebody has been imprisoned for political reasons, for no other reason than their political views. It's completely disgraceful. But then again, so is everything Israel does vis-a-vis the Palestinians. And I suppose the question I have for you is this. I mean, given, do you not think at this stage Israel is just, has no interest whatsoever in a reasonable or just settlement, and is just playing the world community in whatever way it can, either by ignoring them or pretending to negotiate? But in fact, all it's ever been interested in is creating facts on the ground to expand the territory of Israel and destroy any hopes for Palestinian self-determination. I mean, isn't that just the reality? And I mean, my strongly held view has always been, and it's just been confirmed, I mean, you know, as a biographical note, the only reason I'm involved in politics was because actually on Christmas Eve in 1987, I was in Bethlehem. And the day before, I was in Al-Fawar refugee camp with Palestinian friends I'd been working with on a Israeli moshav down in the Dead Sea, okay? And I saw, we were chased around Bethlehem, there was shooting, there was full-scale conflict going on in Al-Fawar refugee camp. It was terrifying and shocking. And that's the reason I became involved in politics when I came back to Ireland. And since then, all I have seen is the situation has just got worse and worse and worse. And despite all the hand-wringing and the tokenistic concern for the Palestinian cause, the situation just gets worse. So do you not think it's time that we sort of really have to be more robust in just calling Israel for what it is, a rogue state, that it's pointless trying to negotiate with them because they're not interested in negotiating, and that we have to now treat them and characterise this thing in the same way as we characterised apartheid South Africa? And if we don't do that, I would put it to you that we're in fact assisting the Israelis, and if you like, the enemies of Palestine, in allowing the conflict to be characterized as a sort of intractable fight between Arabs and Jews, right? Which suits them. That's the way they want to present it. Because if it can be presented like that, well then people in Europe just switch off and say, well, that's the sort of stuff that goes on in the Middle East, right? And it's only if we can break through that narrative and say, this isn't about Jews versus Arabs or religion or a clash of civilizations. It's none of those things. This is about a racist, aggressive, rogue state. And it is, and I'd just be interested in your comments on this, it is also about a network of despotic states in the region that are also determined to crush their own populations. Whether it's the al-Sisi regime in Egypt, whether it's the Saudi regime, whether it's the various Gulf regimes, that they have always been about crushing their own people. Israel is, if like, the most extreme example of this. But the West has played at best a duplicitous game, because it has always continued to support Israel. And it can trade with them, treat them as a normal state, despite their flagrant human rights violations and so on and so forth. And it continues to arm and support the worst elements in the Middle East against the Arab population. So I just ask for the, and just very final point on this, is in that context, do we not need to now, as a way of breaking through that cul-de-sac, start to talk about the one person, one vote? As the one person, one vote, the one state solution, okay. The one Palestine, because it cuts through that narrative, which suits them, You know, because if you know, the history of partition has always, just last point, Chair. The history of partition of any land has always been civil war and perennial fight. And I think that the two-state solution, it's become apparent that's what it does, is it just leads to a perennial fight over where you're going to draw the boundaries, and that fight never ends. Would it not be better to cut across that by talking about one person, one vote as the way to reframe what is at stake in Palestine?
Okay, thank you very much.